Difference between fasting and non-fasting cholesterol. Serum cholesterol measurement is one of the most conducted blood tests. Diabetes, heart attacks, strokes and narrowing of arteries are on the rise, and the World Health Organization has recommended serum cholesterol as one of the assessment tools used to determine the risk of having an ischemic heart disease. Apart from this, very valid reason many people get their cholesterol levels checked often so they can control it with diet and drugs as needed. These tests are very important to the apparently healthy individuals as well as the heart patients. It is always worthwhile to know the slight differences between the two tests. Fasting and non-fasting cholesterol levels are based upon the general body metabolism, especially cholesterol metabolism. Our diet contains cholesterols and fatty acids. Fat components get emulsified and broken down in the small intestine. Fats break up into fatty acids, glycerol and cholesterols. Cholesterol is fat soluble, so it passes into the intestinal lining cells directly. Inside the cells, cholesterols and fatty acids get compacted into chylomicrons. As chylomicrons, cholesterol gets transported into the splanchnic circulation and then into the liver. Liver takes up the cholesterol in chylomicrons. Liver also synthesizes cholesterol using an enzyme called pyroreductase, which is very active at night. That is why doctors prescribe statins, pyroreductase inhibitors, at night. Liver forms very low-density lipoproteins, LDL, which contains a lot of fatty acids and glycerol. At capillaries in end organs, these very low-density lipoproteins get broken down partially, and some of the fatty acids and glycerol get absorbed. The result is intermediate-density lipoproteins. At end organs, cells produce cholesterol. These cholesterols get transferred onto intermediate-density lipoproteins forming high-density lipoproteins, HDL. These bring cholesterol back to the liver for recirculation. The liver is a hub that brings all the synthetic and catabolic pathways together. Fasting is an important modulator of all these pathways. Fasting spends all readily available glucose from the liver within minutes. Then glycogen breakdown commences. After about half an hour, fat breakdown starts. The enzymes that break down very low-density lipoproteins get deactivated and hormone-sensitive lipase located inside fat cells get activated. Therefore, broken down fat goes to the liver as substrates for gluconeogenesis, also known as synthesis of new glucose.